About ready. Racing. Away nicely to Bella on the inside. The White Witch is away well. My Marlena going forward. Rebel Zone's going to be handy. Bred to Flirt is back on the inside ahead of God's Blue Sky. Tishan Gwyn got caught out of shade. White is racing in a four spot, trying to get over one off the fence, and does so, or not quite. Rebel Zone pushed up and kept her out wider. God's Blue Sky three deep. It's trying to press forward as Tishan Gwyn looks to get over now. Bred to Flirt's in an awkward spot, back on the inside of Rebel Zone, followed by Elite Time. Queen of Sol is ridden quietly back third last on the outside for Carberry, and two away is Ambergate Rose before the corner, and My Marlene has got the lead from the White Witch and Tishan and Queen on the outside. Tabella the inside. God's Blue Sky out wider. Rebel Zone the centre. Queen of Sol travelled up pretty well out wider. Back on the inside is Bred to Flirt. Ravilla's looking for the run back on the inside. Got pushed back in there by Rebel Zone as they straighten up. Inside the 250. My Marlena has got the lead from the White Witch. Queen of Sol is starting to put in a really good burst. Ambergate Rose is down the outside. My Marlena in front. Queen of Sol the outside with Ambergate Rose. My Marlena in front. Queen of Sol's getting there though. Queen of Sol has raced to My Marlena. Ambergate Rose late, but Queen of Sol. Queen of Sol too good. Beat Ambergate Rose. My Marlena and fourth in the White Witch. And then Bred to Flirt. Further back, Tishan Gwyn. And now followed by Elite Time, Rebel Zone, God's Blue Sky, and Tabella ran last. Queen of Sol. Very good. Queen of Sol for Frank Smith. Gets the money. Coming with a big run. Number two is the winner.
You can do. Well, it's Queen of Sol winning there, Scott. We were happy to see drifting, you were saying. If you saw $5, you'd be very happy with that. Well, you've seen more than that. Ambergate Rose was finishing off really strongly down the outside of the track. You preface that that may be the place to be, sort of in this back half of the program, but Queen of Sol lucky enough to hold on.
A lot of punters there, Britt. It was unfortunate for Bred to Flirt because she never saw daylight at any stage. By the time that Brad Rewilla got her into a gap, the race was all over. So if you burnt your fingers today, you'd be following up to get some back next start on her. But for Queen of Sol, Britt, that's exactly how she trialled. She sat back, she was kept cool and calm, and Paddy Carberry elected to just cut the corner inside of God's Blue Sky, who was three deep the trip and fading. And in the end, it was too strong for them. 2, 3, 10 and 8. She's always shown that ability. It's great to see her finally breaking through.
It is indeed, and to all the owners out here on course as well, enjoying their Sunday and enjoying it a little bit more now, I dare say, as well. I believe they bred this mare, and they're tasting success here today, getting ready to lead her in as Simon Miller comes into the yard. Simon, first up here today, were you expecting her to win?
Yeah, it was, Brittany. Her work behind the scenes has been exceptional, and probably only a little bit of room improvement-wise was her coat. It's not through yet, but her work and her action has been really fluent, and her gallop Tuesday was really good.
Has she improved from one preparation to the next?
She's always had the ability, but she mentally couldn't deal with it all, and now she's dealing with it all. She actually still had the pre-race earmuffs on her, but she paraded really well, which maybe it's all coming together for her.
Is that just a maturity thing and experience at the races? Is she just a horse that can be a little bit hot?
Yeah, I think that whole family does, but it's a good question because she's by Daniel Express. Well, they're all lunatics, so she fit the mould there. But I think just with holding her hand and looking after her will rip the rewards now.
And nice to have all the owners out on track here today to enjoy it.
Yeah, it is really good. So we've got Jason Crony's colours in the winner's circle again. So and we've got Frank Smith out here. And as you'd know, I was late into the meeting yard because I was on the beanbag playing games. I actually had to half watch the race and half watch my little one. But she met her idol, so she's happy.
For those that don't know what we're talking about, Simon's daughter Olivia here at the races today, and I introduced her to the beanbag corner, and she said, "I want Daddy to have a go on the beanbags." I said, "Don't you think Daddy will break the beanbags?" And she matter-of-factly just said, "No, he will not." Yeah. So she has good faith in you.
Well, I didn't. I haven't gone in them because I think that by the look of me at the moment, Brittany, I reckon they'd be bursting everywhere.
how are you going on the video games in there? Perth Racing have a nice little corner at Belmont of video games for the kids. Do you have a go?
Well, it worked out good for me because while she was playing that, I was nicking her chips.
Won't be happy with you. Well done on the win.
Thanks, Brittany.
There is Simon Miller after the victory of Queen of Soul. And well, I don't know how much of the race he actually got to watch because Olivia would have been very demanding of his attention and making sure that he was right on top of playing these video games in the corner of Belmont Park. So he will have had one eye on the screen just to see how Queen of Soul was travelling and would have been very happy to see Paddy Carberry going across the line first here. We'll get a word from Paddy before taking you to Sha Tin. Paddy Carberry just about to weigh in. He knows the horse well, Scott. She had to lump his 60 kilos. He gets the tick of approval from stewards on the scales, and he's now catching up with Scott.
We'll get a bit of a word from Paddy Carberry on this mare. Paddy, she's always shown enough ability. It's for some pretty patient connections. They seem very happy to see her finally put it all together.
Yeah, it's good to get her back at the races. They've had to be really patient. She's had a few issues along the way and probably worked in her favour a little bit because she's such a big horse. But, yeah, good to get a win for Jason and the team. It's good that after Christmas, when we all head down to Busselton, he'll be shouting first drink, so it's all good.
I was watching you in the run and you were tracking the horse three deep with cover, and then at the top of the straight, I could watch you and I could see what was going through your mind, just that horse wasn't going to take you far enough into the straight. Come inside, is that the plan?
Yeah, it was sort of floating a fair way from home. She stumbled really bad at the start. She was a bit fresh and a bit fidgety in the gates, and she's a bit of a big clunker anyway, but the best part was she settled really well on the run. And sort of when the horse in front of me wobbled off, she travelled straight through there and took a while to get through her gears, but she let down good, and I think she seems to have matured quite a bit, so hopefully there's bigger things for her to come.
Will she ever mature to a stage where the pre-race ear muscle can come off?
Possibly not.
Congratulations on it, Paddy.
Thank you, cheers.
There's Paddy Carberry combined with Simon Miller, and Queen of Soul takes out race number 6. Sky Thoroughbred Central, it's off to Sha Tin. Does she make you feel